Hi, my name's Chris, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through the process of turning a blank nuBuilder Forte database into a usable invoice creation application. And I'm also going to show you how to search your data. First of all, I'm going to create a form and table using the Fast Form Builder. I'm including a unique code, name, and 3 address lines to sort data belonging to customers. After I've built the form, I'll go to the new form's properties and make some changes, including renaming the form and resizing its browse columns. Now, I'll resize and align individual objects, and I'll also adjust and rearrange objects together. Now I'm going to go through the same process to create my second form, this time to store data for products that certain customers can buy. I'm including a unique code, a name, a price, and a customer lookup. When modifying the customer lookup, I'll open it via the form object list. I'll choose a form in the Lookup tab and scroll through the available fields to use as the code and description. I'll use the SQL Builder to change the statement used to display the form's browse columns. Now the third fast form to create is the invoice form, which will include an auto number, a date, a customer lookup, and totals. Next, I'm going to get the customer lookup in the invoice form functioning correctly. Once set up, I'm adding 3 lines of new set form value PHP code. Once a customer is chosen in the lookup function, this code will fill out the address lines by grabbing the values from the customer table. At this point, I'm going to build the final fast form, a subform called Invoice Item. Now I can update the subform object on the invoice form to display the invoice item subform. To limit the invoice to only show items available to the customer selected in the lookup, I'll go back to the product browse form and clone it, and call it product by customer. Once I've done that, I'll add an extra line of SQL utilizing nuBuilder's hash cookies variable so that the subform's product lookup will restrict results shown based on the current invoice customer lookup ID. Now I'll add some PHP code to run after the product lookup has been chosen, and it'll populate the price field. Lastly, I'll set up the calc fields to work correctly. Back out to the browse screen, I'll join the customer table with the invoice table to show the customer's ID as customer's name instead. nuBuilder Forte has a robust search and sort tool in every browse form. When searching, I can sort any column in ascending or descending order, or I can keyword search with singular characters or words. I can also search using multiple characters or words separated with spaces. I can turn columns off so that they aren't included in the keyword search. Finally, I'll use the report builder to build a printable invoice. To begin with, I'm going to use the SQL Builder to link the customer and invoice table to display the customer names. Then in the Report Builder, I'll select the SQL and add the fields I want from both the invoice and customer tables. I'll rename the column titles, resize the width, and select the total as the column to be summed up at the bottom of the report. I'll also order the report by the invoice number column. Before running the report, I'll rename the report and I'll change the format of the totals. Now I can run the report and generate a PDF file with the required data. This is now a fully functioning customer product invoicing application using nuBuilder Forte. Thanks for watching, and don't forget you can go to forums.nuBuilder.com for further help and tips.